If you look at the way banks analyze credit risk and you look at the underserved, the reason why a lot of people like the underserved market can't get access to credit is banks use very dated systems. If we just take a microcosm of just in what we have in North America, some of the data that could impact someone's ability to get credit isn't being captured by a lot of these financial institutions or credit bureaus. So when you look at it just from here, you realize that there's an issue already. And then when you expand that to other markets, especially emerging markets, you see that that need is even greater in those markets. So we piloted in Kenya with a couple customers, but we pivoted to launch in Nigeria because the need in Nigeria is even greater. You know, Nigeria has a population of 200 million people and 22 commercial banks, but only 44 million people have something called a bank verification number, or BVN, which allows you to get banking and lending services. So when you look at a big, large population and you look at only a small section have this BVN number, which means they have access to banking and lending services, it made more sense for us to focus more in the Nigerian market.
A typical digital lender, if you want to get a loan from them, so typically, you know, you can get a loan from either their web app or a mobile app. But typically, as a digital lender, if you want to give out a loan, the first thing you do is to carry out your KYC, meaning that you have to know the customer that is coming to get a loan from you. There are a lot of lenders that have started businesses. After 6 months, they went under. You know, there are a lot of borrowers that have got funds, and, you know, they didn't pay back. A lot of borrowers have also tried to get funds, and you know their loans were not approved, even when they thought and they knew that that they had good credit history.
It's hard for individuals to get loans because majority of the unbanked sector, like I mentioned earlier, they are strictly cash in hand basis. So usually they don't run a lot of their transactions to financial institutions. So there's not really enough data on them to be able to analyze and know if they are credit worthy to be able to give out facilities. The entirety of the application after its analysis and everything might not meet the risk criteria that has been set, so they will be denied the loans. Mainly because, like I mentioned, the element of risk criteria is broad.
Yeah, it's an interesting question. I mean, I think it plays into the fact that there is a lot of data in underserved markets. It's just, one, you have to be able to find it, and two, you have to aggregate it, process it, and drive the key insights from it, and I think that's the challenge.
The drive to start this is very personal. My natural instinct is to try to help people, and working in banking and seeing the struggles that people are going through also fed into that as well.
I took an undergrad course in economics and finance, and I really enjoyed it. And so I was always kind of looking for an opportunity where I could enter that market. And, you know, Michael came with this idea, and, you know, he needed somebody to help develop the software and the product. And I've had, you know, quite a few years of experience in product development and software development. So I thought that that would be the perfect fit for me. So the advantage of using machine learning in our products is that we are able to provide the same services that loan officers do, but we do it faster and with a higher accuracy. Machine learning is heavily used to determine the credit scoring models and how they're applied.
Rent typically is not recorded by most credit bureaus. In fact, you'd be hard pressed to find a credit bureau that records rent payments. But that shows, you know, that tells something. That tells you something about this individual. If they're paying their rent on time every single month or every single year, this is information that is not typically captured by the lender or the credit bureau or whoever. But here's the information right here. This is why this person has the ability to finance this loan, to collect this loan and pay back in time. In banking, we talk about the 5 C's of credit. One of them is capacity. Does this individual have the capacity to get this loan, collect this loan, and actually pay this loan on time? We're not just looking for flaws, we're also looking for the good attributes as well that we can highlight. The average prediction accuracy is around 50%. Our prediction accuracy at the very bare bones minimum is 80%.
Any loan where Periculum or Periculum's products detect low probability of default, all those loans should be paid back in full. That's what it means for the banks. for consumers or people who are taking out loans, what it would mean is that Periculum is able to de-risk them, and people who should be able to get a loan are getting a loan.
For next year, we're going to start looking at other markets. So we'll start looking at Kenya, Ghana, and Egypt. Eventually, we'll expand to the Francophone countries in Africa. And then we'll start to also look at the Latin American market. So specifically, there's a lot of interest that we're getting from Colombia and Mexico. So we'll start looking at those markets. And then our five-year plan is eventually going to Southeast Asia and eventually be in all emerging markets globally. You know, there's a $5 trillion lending gap. And our vision and mission is to do our best to try and close that lending gap.